I'm here in Chloe to fix the auto greeting. It's not working for 6.1 in Chloe 3D. I'm going to share with you some links below. Right here, let me show you this side chart, which is woman side chart, and I got this form from alvanon.com. You can go check it out, or you can just click on that link to open. I also have this petite side chart, and if I scroll down here, I get to see in the columns right here where you get to find out more information about the avatar side and so forth.
Hi designistas, I'm Rose from Encoded Fashion. I have some tips on how to fix auto grading in Chloe 3D does not work. Are you ready? Let's do it.
So now I'm going to come back to Chloe and we're going to fix the auto grading. It's not working in Chloe 3D. Okay, first of all, I want to point out that it's important. Before the auto grading to work, we have to do a few things here. First, we want to save this project's file to a garments file. For example, this legging right here is a project's file because it is .zprj, that is stand for projects file. So we are going to go to file and we want to save that as a garments file. So save as, and then scroll down here and you see this garment, click on it to select. Then I'm going to name it legging garment, underscore garment, sorry. Then I'm going to just save it under download and then I'm going to click on save to save. Next, I'm going to marquee select all these pattern pieces, then press down the delete or backspace on the keyboard to delete. After that, I'm going to zoom out a little bit so we can see the whole avatar. Then I'm going to add that garments file back to the workspace. To do so, I'm going to come over here to file and then I'm going to select. You can select open or add, doesn't matter. So if you select add right here, select add garment, then navigate to the garment that we saved earlier, which is legging underscore garment. Click on it to select. Then I'm going to come over here to open. Then this open pose and sizes pop up. Would you like to load the avatar poses and size? I'm going to select no. And as you can see right here, now we have the garments file loaded into Chloe workspace. So by default, the pattern pieces are selected. So I'm going to come over here to this property editor and scroll down. We want to change the particle distance to 20. I'm going to click and highlight it and then type in 20. Then I'm going to press return to enter on the keyboard to confirm. Okay. After that, I'm going to change the avatar size. Chloe have many different sizes. Let me show you. So just go to avatar, double click on it to open. Then come down here. This is important, guys. You have to use the underscore V2 based on this avatar because Camilla 6.1 is avatar version 2, which is underscore V2. So what that means, I have to use in this female underscore V2 sizes. So I'm going to double click on it to open. Then I'm going to come to size here, this size folder, double click on it. Then I can select any size I wanted. For example, if I want to change it to Missy, just double click on that folder and I can select right here. Okay, let's just adjust this window to make it a little bit bigger right here. So I can select, 2, 4, 6, 8, however I want. I can just double click on it right there like that to apply the size onto the avatar. And as you can see, I can tell the size is changed because the pant is a little bit smaller. I draft this pants pattern on a default avatar size, okay, which is extra small. And I can see right here the pattern kind of merge into her skin like that. So for this example, instead of using these messy sizes, I'm going to come over here and use my own custom avatar size. So I'm going to just double click on there to open. Then I'm going to change the avatar size to medium. Once again, I can double click or drag and drop. So this time I'm going to just click, drag it, and then drop onto the avatar to change the sizes. Okay, as you can see, the avatar much taller and a little bit bigger. Now I'm going to come over here to this objects browser and click on this pattern grading icon. Okay, then click on this add button to add a group size pattern. After that, I'm going to, you can add many sizes you want to do the grading, but for this example, I'm going to just grade to one size. So I'm going to just click right here to name that to medium. Then I'm going to press return enter on the keyboard to confirm. Then I'm going to come over here once again and my key selects all these pattern pieces because we want to assign that grading onto that pattern pieces, okay? Then I'm going to come over here to that object browser once again and select right there. You see the twirling arrow to assign, okay? So this is what happened. After we select assign, you see these points appear onto any pattern points that we have onto the pattern. After that, I'm going to come over here to this auto grading icon, click on it to select. Then this auto grading window pop up. So by default, we have maintain pattern curvature to 100%, that's perfect. And maintain graphic size box is unchecked. Because a pattern have no graphics, we do not need to check that box. After that, I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Okay, so as you can see right here, we just created a pattern and I'm going to kind of space in them a little bit because they stack on top of each other. And the best practice with this guy, we want to space in them first before we grade. So I didn't do that. So that was a bad idea. So I'm going to just my key and select these pattern pieces and move a little bit to the left, okay? Just like that. Now we have more room between the pattern pieces. After that, I'm going to Command or Control plus letter A to select all these pattern pieces and right click and select Strengthen. After that, I'm going to press down the spacebar to simulate. Okay, now I'm going to press down the spacebar once again to stop the simulation. And I'm going to unstrengthen that pattern piece as well. So right click and select unstrengthen. Okay, so as you can see, we just finished graded this legging pattern in Close 3D. So the next video, I'm going to show you how to save these pattern pieces. Either we want to save it all the sizes, or we want to save it just one size. Okay. Thanks so much for watching, Designista. I hope you find this video useful and remember to sub, click on the bell, so you will always have these videos in your library. Love it.